Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I created this web app. This is a task management app, and I'm going to show you the different areas of the app and how to recreate this. All right, so here is a version. This was actually the first one that I created. And then what I did was, after developing this one, I asked Gemini to write me a prompt that I can use to recreate this in one step. So let's go over this one. We have the goal area where you can add your goal, and it shows up here. The next is this task area. Let's say I'm going to add a new task. I'll say create a YouTube video and add that to video creation. Add urgent as the priority. I'm going to add a start date of today. And let's say I'm going to do this for a month. I'm going to focus on creating YouTube videos twice a week. So I'll select Mondays and Thursdays. All right. And you can put a duration if you want. And then here I can do YouTube video as a business area and add task. All right, so now you can see that the task shows up here. Okay, and then you can edit it if you want, or you can delete the task. You can filter by whatever category you want or priority, and it will display that here as well. All right, now moving on to the next one. This is the calendar tab. So you can see the create YouTube video here. It shows up here because we have it for Mondays and Thursdays. So if I were to go over to next week, Monday, you can see that task shows up here as well. And then you can cross it off. This is the weekly area. You can cross things off here as well. And then you have the monthly area. And this is more like an overview. So you're not going to be crossing tasks off here, making any changes. This just gives you an idea of what your month looks like. And then we do have the AI assistant here. So let me show you how it works. All right, so the instruction is to list the calendar templates on Etsy weekly. All right, so I'm going to send this to the AI assistant to see what happens. So it's going to think for a little bit. But what's nice about this is like a mini Gemini, meaning that it has context, it has memory, and it's reading your calendar and making suggestions of how things should be. So here is the suggested task, and you can click on it to make changes. So if you don't want it to be medium priority, you can change it to something else and save changes. And then now when we go to our task, let's show all categories. You can see that the task shows up here weekly. And here you can see that it shows up in our today's task list. For the AI assistant part to work, you do need to add your Gemini app key. If you don't add this part, it's not going to work. So if you're not interested in using this, you don't need to add your Gemini app key. So a few other things I want to say is that this is a web app that stores all the information locally. So this is not going to be something that you can use here and then use on your phone and then use on another computer. I believe there's a way to do that, but that is not what I did here. This is something that I'm only going to be using on my work computer because I primarily work on this system. Now, if for whatever reason I have to change my computer or I need to use a different device, you can go to the setup tab and export your data and then open this file on your browser and import your data. So that's what this is for. So again, if you're looking for a system that you need to use in the cloud, this is not going to work. Like I said, there is a way to host it in the cloud. And once I have that sorted, I will make a different video on how to do. Next, what I'm going to do is show you how to create this. So I already have the prompt. It's really long. I'm going to have this available in my Patreon. It's going to be free. You just need to sign up to be a part of my Patreon. You get this document and you can copy the prompt. So it's about 4 pages long. But what's nice about this is that when you start from this, you're not starting from scratch. So let's go ahead and copy this. So I'm copying everything. I'm going to create this in Gemini, but I'm going to show you what happens if I use this exact prompt in other large language models. All right, so we're back here in my Gemini account. This is a brand new chat. And what I'm going to do is just paste it right here. The things I do is I make sure that 2.5 Pro is selected. And then I select Canvas because I want it to show up immediately. That way I can make changes as necessary. Canvas is selected, the right version is selected, and hit submit. It opens up the preview. When it is completed, the preview button will be activated and then you can see what it looks like. So it's gonna take some time. In the meantime, I'm gonna switch over to ChatGPT. All right, so here we are in my ChatGPT account. I do use the paid version. And when I'm using a prompt like this, I change it to the thinking mode because I just think it works better. And then I'm gonna paste it here, hit enter. And then of course, this is gonna take a long time. So we'll come back to Gemini. Looks like Gemini is done. Right now the time is 11:50. So it probably took about 5-6 minutes. This is with one single prompt. Now, if we take a look, obviously some parts are missing. We don't have any of the tabs that we had in the previous version. We have the icons here and we have the menu to change the color and we have the dashboard, but that's it. I don't know why, but this is definitely not helpful because we cannot do anything with this. What I'm going to do is do it one more time. So I'm going to open another chat and see if I can get something closer to what I got before. All right. So I'm going to make sure I click on Canvas, click submit. In the meantime, let's go to ChatGPT and see what it's doing for us. All right. So it's still working its way through the code. It's a lot of information that it has to work through. and you can see the button is not active, so it's not yet ready. The other one we can try is DeepSeek. Sometimes it kind of works, but I think because a lot of people use it at the same time, it tends to freeze. So it would create something, and then when I try to make tweaks, it is unable to do it. So I'm going to paste the exact same prompt. You can see this is the exact same prompt, and click on send and see what happens. All right. And DeepSeek does have the preview as well, and it is going to open it up after it's done. All right. So we're back here in Gemini and it is done. As you can see, this is the session. Here is what the second prompt looks like. It's the exact same thing. Let's take a look at what it created. So much better. We have our dashboard. We have our goal area. All right. We have our task area, calendar, AI assistant, and our setup. So for some reason, the first time it didn't work well, but this looks much better. And then we have the volume control area, and then we have our different themes. All right, so that is pretty good for the first go around, but you can see that a few things are not working. So first of all, we have this error, and I usually click fix error just in case there is an error that I'm not aware of that it needs to fix. This will obviously take some time. We'll come back and see what it looks like. All right, so here is ChatGPT. I already got this pop-up that says it's too long right here. I always get this message when I try to create a web app that is really intense. So again, if you have more experience with creating web apps, especially using prompts to create them, put a comment in the comment section below and let me know. But we do have this preview button, so let's take a look to see what it looks like. All right, so actually not too bad, right? So the dashboard kind of looks like the original one, and we have a lot of tabs. So we have our goal area, and again, the goal area is never developed. Right here, you can see the goal area has a placeholder instruction, so it's doing exactly what we instructed it to do. So let's go to the task area. Doesn't look bad, right? You can add your task, and right now I'm not sure if things work. We'll come back and test it out. I'm just looking at the structure to see what it looks like. All right, the calendar works. Looks like a nice monthly calendar. Let's switch it to daily. All right, it looks pretty good, right? And the weekly calendar, right? It looks good. I'm actually pretty surprised. If you have ChatGPT, go ahead and try it. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I just get inconsistent results with it, which is why I tend to lean towards using Gemini. And then we have our AI assistant named Spark and our setup tab. All right, so not bad. With just one prompt, you can create this. And then later on, you can go through, check the areas that are not working and fix it. I'm gonna change the theme to something else to see if it works. All right, so it looks like it created the dark theme for all of them. I was expecting it to actually switch to something lighter, but it didn't, which is fine. Again, this is something that you can work with AI prompt and tweak it. So you can see, for example, these are not legible because it's using dark text. You can chat with ChatGPT and tell it exactly what's not working. Sometimes I would use a screenshot. So I would take a screenshot of this area, place it in the chat so it's very clear what I'm talking about. All right, so we're in DeepSeek and it's still working its way through. This usually takes the longest, so I'm not surprised. All right, so we're back in Gemini. I wanna test the task area to see if it works, and if it doesn't, then I can start making changes. I have list a planner on Etsy. Let's say priority of high, we'll do 1 month and change the frequency to daily. Let's save task, shows up here, which is nice. Let's go to our calendar to see if that part worked. Okay, so it looks like we have it here. It's not really showing up everywhere. The weekly view, it shows up here, but it doesn't show up anywhere else. And then the daily view, it probably shows up on the first and nothing else. So just making sure it is daily. Back to this, it is daily. So that part is not working. We'll work on that first. I'm going to prompt Gemini to fix that part. All right, so what I typed was the frequency is not working correctly, doesn't show up in the calendar as expected. So you can see I'm using very natural language. Click enter and see what happens. One thing I would mention is while you're in this creative mode in Gemini, it's not going to save what you already did. But when you're using this on your browser, it's actually going to save it. So the task I entered earlier is not showing up, but it's okay. We'll just add it one more time. I'm using a different task, edit YouTube video. All right, add some more information. Start and the end date like we did before, change it to daily. All right, so it shows up here. Let's go to our calendar and you can see now it worked. So if you go to weekly, you can see edit YouTube showing up daily from the first. And for the daily task, you can see it showing up here. If we change it to the next day, it shows up. So that worked. And then you can go through each section to make sure everything works. And if it doesn't work, I would prompt Gemini to fix it. Right now, I'm just testing the color area to see if they look good, because sometimes it would use text that doesn't work with the background. So this looks okay. And I'm not going to test every single section here, but when you create yours, chat with Gemini and fix it and keep testing and going back and forth. And then when everything works okay, then then you can say, okay, develop the goals area or add an additional tab or whatever you need to do. And hopefully you can get to something that works for you. Before we go, I'm going to do two more things. I'm going to download this code and show you how to open it to your browser. And we also need to check on the one that we created in DeepSeek. All right, it actually is done. I don't know how long it took because I wasn't fully paying attention to this. Probably took somewhere around 15 minutes or so if I had to guess. Let's click run. So we'll click run to see the preview. So click on that. All right, here's what it looks like. Actually, it doesn't look too bad. So one thing you'll notice is that these charts are stacked, and it's only because of the narrow part of the screen. If I were to open this in a browser where it would take over the entire space, this will not be stacked. They'll be next to each other, just like we had with the other ones. Doesn't look bad, right? It really followed the prompt and created something. And then let's check out the other ones. The task area looks pretty good. The calendar, let's go to the daily view, not bad. The weekly view, but you can see that some things are not working. So this crosses off, and when you uncheck it, nothing happens. So this is something you would definitely want to fix. The AI assistant looks okay. As far as if it works, that's something else you would have to test. And then we have our setup area where you can add your Gemini key. So not bad at all. I'm actually pretty impressed. So all of them worked pretty good today. The only one I'm not testing today is Canva. And the reason I'm not testing it is because Canva has a limit with the prompt that you can use. And this is way too long. All right. So I wanted to test the exact same prompt using different LLMs so you can see what it looks like. But another thing you could do is use a shorter version of the prompt and then try it out in Canva. All right. So the last thing we're going to do is to download this and open it up in our browser. One thing I like about DeepSeek is you can just download this directly. It will download the file, the HTML file to your computer, and you can just open that directly. Same thing with ChatGPT. You go here, click on these three dots, and you can download this and open it up in your browser. Back here in Gemini, I don't really see anything that we can use to download, except I'm missing something. So what I usually do is click on this and I copy the entire code. All right. And then I'm going to go to my computer and open up my text program, click on new document, and I'm going to paste it right here. So let's name this task management demo. All right. And then what's important is adding .html and enter. And for some reason, it will add the TXT, but we should be able to fix that later. And I'm going to save this so you can go to file and save or use your shortcut key, which is Command S for me because I'm using a Mac. And then I close it and reopen it. I'm going to click once, like I'm trying to rename it, and then hit enter. Right. And then it's going to prompt me if I want to keep TXT or HTML. I'll click on that. So right now it's saved as HTML. All right, and just double click to open it up, and it's going to use your default browser. And here's what it looks like right here. Okay, so just clicking through, everything should be exactly how it was when we were in the Gemini system. Looks pretty good. All right, so this is the ChatGPT one. I'm gonna download it and click here to open it. And here's what it looks like. So again, this is my Chrome browser, and this is what it looks like. Everything works as it worked while we're in ChatGPT. All you need to do is download the code, make sure it's saved as HTML, and then open it up on your preferred browser. All right, so that brings me to the end of this video. I want to know if you found this useful, if you're going to be creating something like this for task management, or you prefer to keep using Google Sheets, which is what I'm used to using, but now I'm transitioning into this, or if you like to use Notion, which is what I used to do before I went back to Google Sheets. So I've gone back and forth a lot, but I really like this because of the AI parts. It just makes things a little bit better, and it removes some of the limitations that you might have with Google Sheets, but it is not in the cloud, and I haven't figured out how to move it to the cloud yet, but I'm sure that is something that once I figure that out, I'll be happy to create a video on how to do that. And then one final thing, there will be a link to my Patreon. You don't have to be a paid member to access this. Go ahead and copy it, paste it into your preferred LLM, and let me know if it works for you. I'm curious to see what your result would be like. Let me know if you want me to test out another web app. I have plenty of them that I have created. So if you have something else that you want me to try, let me know. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.